Hello, this is Colonel Celestino Ortino Perez. I'm a teacher here at the U.S. Army War College, and this is episode 7 of the Strategy is Performance series. Today, I want to do something a little bit different. I want to tell you about a problem that a colleague and I have been working on. Dr. Megan Hennessy is works in our educational methodology section here at the U.S. Army War College, and I have been wondering about student assessments. And I want to let you know how we're thinking about this problem and invite you to provide feedback as to whether this way of looking at the problem is actually correct. And then what are some ways that we can improve our assessments of student learning? And so I'm specifically thinking about strategic thinking. And here at the U.S. Army War College, we have three departments in the School of Strategic Land Power. And one of them relates to national security and strategy. The second one relates to military strategy, plans, and operations. And the third one focuses on leadership and management. So one of the concerns we have is, how do we know that the stuff that we're trying to teach the students via the curricula is actually being taught in a way that the students are able to use it and recall it and employ it at will when they leave? All right, so there's three ways of doing assessments. I posit. One of them relates to relational learning dynamics. And this has both individual and group dynamics. So when I'm talking about relational learning dynamics at the individual level, we're asking questions such as, is the student self-aware? Is the student aware that he or she has biases that the student might be susceptible to? Is the student open and inquisitive about learning new information? And does the student exhibit the traits of intellectual humility, or is the student arrogant? Well, these are individual attributes that we attempt to measure. At the group level, when we have healthy relational dynamics, we hope to see at the group level of, say, during a problem-solving exercise, that the group is engaged in fruitful collaboration and dialogue, that they are engaged in debate and argumentation in the highest sense of the term, where they're questioning assumptions, they're questioning each other's causal logics about why things might happen if they intervene, etc. These are both important. But my argument is that much of the talk about assessing strategic thinking and assessing the curriculum goes to this area of learning. Everything we're trying to measure is looking at this in many cases, and we're ignoring two other components of what we should be assessing. So what are the second? The second one is learning transfer. So this relates specifically to whether the curriculum and the material within it is actually being taught in an effective way to the students. And that's called learning transfer. At the individual level at the U.S. Army War College, we have oral examinations in the spring. This is close to when the students are graduating. And the students are asked questions where they are they're expected to apply the knowledge that they gained during the school year to a situation that's hypothetical relating to national security or military strategy or leadership and management. So this is accomplished. The question becomes, if it's true the strategy is performance, and the strategy, when it's performed, is performed in as a group where multiple stakeholders are involved in trying to understand and intervene in a specific problem, my concern is that we're not assessing learning transfer at the group level. Now remember, the overall theme of this video series is that strategy is not simply a discipline that one studies like history or political science or psychology. That strategy is those things, but it's also and fundamentally performance. We are concerned about creating strategic thinkers who can act in the world in the face of intractable problems and make the world better, regardless of what domain we're talking about. If that's true, and strategy is always done in a group level, we need to come up with measures that look at how well we are achieving learning transfer in our students. And then the third area that we're neglecting, I think, relates to group performance and its level. So suppose you have a group that has learned the lessons at a certain level, a competent level, that we're that we've tried to teach them at the Army War College. Now, how do we differentiate this group from another group in terms of performance? What we want to know is, when are groups performing better and when are groups performing worse with respect to strategic thinking, with respect to problem solving? And I think this is fundamentally a group dynamic that we're trying to assess, and it's one that we're neglecting. Okay, so what we want to know is, if we have the measures for this, would those then inform how we can improve our curriculum from one year to the next? If we see that if we see that we could be improving in terms of group dynamics with respect to, say, how well students do research on a specific problem, then maybe in the following year we increase the opportunities for research as they do that problem. So once again, I think we're focused on relational learning dynamics. We're able to get at this with survey instruments and maybe some basic observation, but this is pretty generic, right? This can occur well in a business environment, in engineering, in science, or in the military. But we're concerned about military learning transfer, which relates to strategy, military thinking, and leadership. And I'm not sure we're getting at this at the group level. And then finally, we're concerned about identifying groups that are better and groups that are worse, and that informs our curricular improvements from one year to the next. If you have suggestions, reply to this video, leave a message below, and or send an email, and we'd be happy to engage in discussion with you. Thank you very much.